I guess what really bugs me is that we live in a thin world. Fat just never caught on in this country. I always thought there'd be a day when there would be a Pillsbury eat-off. But it never happened. And I have what I call a Cher wish. Just once before I die, I want to see my hip bones. I mean, I don't want any big deal, you know, one of these obvious things, you know, where I can hand my handbag on it, you know, while I'm looking for the car keys. But just a little ripple under the slacks, you know, to let me know. I don't think about it a lot, really, about weight until I go to one of these style shows and I watch all these women go down the runway, and it doesn't make me want to buy clothes at all. It makes me want to cry. To begin with, I have never identified with women who can cross their legs in hot weather. Somehow, I just can't seem to pull the thing. You saw the way I walked out on the stage tonight. And you saw that. I look like a puppy who had just missed the paper, didn't I? I did. It's the way you walk. I watched one model, she came out onto the runway, and she was sort of angled backwards, you know, where the hip bones are out about 3 feet in front of the rest of her body. She walked like a woman who had just sneezed after surgery. And then I watched the next little model. She came out, she walked in a series of jerks, and I figured her for a rash. The next one wore a great big coat with a large patch pockets, and she'd swirl around and dip and sway. And when the show was over, I thought, you know, it's confidence. They've got that confidence that I have to develop. So I pushed myself away from the table. I got up, I squared my shoulders. I stuck my hip bones out wherever they were, and I started toward that door, and you know something? It worked. Everyone was looking at me. Everyone had their eyes on me, and I thought, they think I'm stunning. And finally, one little woman came over and she said, "Honey, you're dragging a piece of toilet tissue on your shoe."